Put on my OJ gloves and watch me kill this shit. Beat the case, then come on and go back from doing some different shit. I'm pulling off a OJ.
I'm smoking up my lungs, this liquor drowning my liver. I'm misusing these prescriptions, these pancakes not for this syrup. Mayweather, all contenders, I eat these rappers for dinner. Put these ratting ass niggas in the sewer, master splinter. Sound like my phone is bugged, give a nigga the jitters. But I don't give a fuck, tell the pigs to kiss my shit up. Yeah, I'm kinda thinner, but goddamn, your jeans are slimmer. I don't want you around my children, you look like a sex offender. Planet of the apes, I'm a G-Unit gorilla. All these rappers claim they killers, while it's who you when you hear them. See, I'm not what you used to, I ain't Sue, I ain't crippin'. I'm a ride a gang nigga, we gon' get in where we fit in.
Put on my OJ gloves and watch me kill this shit. Beat the case, then come on and go back from doing some different shit. I'm pulling off a OJ, OJ. I'm pulling off a OJ. I'm killing these bitches. Put on my OJ gloves and watch me kill this shit. Beat the case, then come on and go back from doing some different shit. I'm pulling off a OJ, OJ. I'm pulling off a OJ. I'm killing these bitches.
Got a new bitch that's so bad. She don't know what she doing, and her ass so round and fat. When she touch me, I'm like boing. I want head and I want tails, so I don't wanna flip a coin. I don't kiss and I don't tell, so a close friend she could join. L pull me from the pins, asking me how things are going. Said the money it is still flowing, yeah, the rider gang is still blowing. And my neck, and my wrist, and my ears, and my fist got diamonds all over shit glowing. And the Lambo ain't got no top, and it's summer yet, but it's hot. You gon' lose your speech when you hit the streets and you see the bitches I got. You better believe it's real, from the Philippines to Brazil. Little Mexican chica, I want you to meet her. People can get it to you pure, 100% uncut. Now nigga, you know what's up.
Put on my OJ gloves and watch me kill this shit. Beat the case, then come on and go back from doing some different shit. I'm pulling off a OJ, OJ. I'm pulling off a OJ. I'm killing these bitches. Put on my OJ gloves and watch me kill this shit. Beat the case, then come on and go back from doing some different shit. I'm pulling off a OJ, OJ. I'm pulling off a OJ. I'm killing these bitches.
So now I'd like to ask one of you brothers to step up and allow me to put blessings.
Put on my OJ gloves and watch me kill this shit. Beat the case, then come on and go back from doing some different shit. I'm pulling off a OJ, OJ. I'm pulling off a OJ. I'm killing these bitches.
MJG, bitch, I got them 8 balls. 4-door garage, bitch, I need 8 calls. They want me locked up, they singing like Akon. Her shot up like a dope head on. Bitch, my life right, and you niggas dead wrong. I will take your head off, see you can't see me head on. I'm getting my head blown, you know what her head on. She got my head gone, shit, I'm about to head on. Kim Zone, that's my destination. Still street, never ended in my resignation. Ding dong, I'm at your doorbell waiting. Who tryna get served? I'm about to do some catering.
Put on my OJ gloves and watch me kill this shit. Beat the case, then come on and go back from doing some different shit. I'm pulling off a OJ, OJ. I'm pulling off a OJ. I'm killing these bitches. Put on my OJ gloves and watch me kill this shit. Beat the case, then come on and go back from doing some different shit. I'm pulling off a OJ, OJ. I'm pulling off a OJ.
Girls, like this May.
Kyle Patterson here. This is the second episode of Ruggid Radio. You remember the format, right? We got nothing but good tunes and interesting stuff for yous all. Today we'll be listening to a piece I've put together called British People Problems. Here. Take a listen to how snooty British people can be. Listen to this.
The British are bound together by far more powerful and problematic forces. A unique set of behaviours and complicated social codes the rest of the world will never understand.
Oh, those silly British. And we'll be playing that later on in the program. Hey, let's bust out the funk. Here's Dr. John's Right Place, Wrong Time on Ruggid Radio. Mm-hmm.
in the right place, but it must have been the wrong time. I done said the right thing, but it must have used the wrong line. I've been on the right trail, but it must have used the wrong car. Hit us in a bad place, and I wonder what's good for. I've been in the right place, but it must have been the wrong time. My head is in a bad place, but I'm having such a good time. I've been running, trying to catch hung up in my mind. Just got to give myself a good talking to this time. Just need a little brain salad surgery. I got to cure my insecurity. I've been in the wrong place, but it must have been the right time. I've been in the right place, but it must have been the wrong song. I've been in the right vein, but it seems like a wrong on. I've been in the right world, but it seems like a wrong, 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 wrong. Sneaking, peeping, hiding out down the street. See my life shaking with every who I meet. Refried confusion as I'm making itself clear. Wonder which way do I go to get on out of here. Cause I've been in the right place, but it must have been the wrong time. And I done said the right thing, but it must have used the wrong line. I took the right road, but it must have took the wrong train. The right move, but I made it at the wrong time. I went in the right trail, but I made it in the wrong call. Head in a good place. Thank you.
All right, thank you for letting me be myself again by Three Dog Night. And that band has numerous hits, many different sounds, you know. I want to show you something interesting. This is combining electric house music with old native powwow music, you know, a blend of music that's not really popular just yet. Let's take a listen. Here's A Tribe Called Red electric powwow right here on Ruggid Radio. Oh, 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 oh. Nah, just kidding, just kidding. Weird stuff, eh? Well, it's time for everyone's favorite fucking commercials. And after that, we got Left Hand Free by Alt J. Left Hand Free, eh? That's what I use on watching porn and my right hand's busy using the mouse, you know what I'm saying?
Hello, this is a message from the Belleville Gleaners Food Bank. What we try to do is provide food to the hungry in need. Offer nutritional guidance and information on the food that we serve. Plus, we help in guidance or information on the closest shelters that are providable for temporary roofs to stay under. While at the same time, we educate the public about poverty. You can help out a cause like this by donating a little bit of your time to help the primary needs of other people. Please, help out human beings like yourself. Thank you. The Christmas holidays are coming up soon, which means it's the time of the year to be generous. When people like you and I need blood, you can help support the cause. By donating some of your time today, you could save a life tomorrow. Our clinic is open from 9 a.m. to 12 p.m. on Dundas Street West. Thank you to all of our donors. Blood, it's in you to give.
Hey, shady baby, I'm hot like the prodigal son. Pick up at the leany, meany, money, moe, and flower, you're the chosen one.
nation with their guns and ammunition. Police at the ease in the street.
Holding out, another breath. London calling, and I don't wanna shout, but while we were talking, I saw you nodding out. London calling, see we ain't got no hide, except for that one with the yellowy eyes. The ice is coming, the sun's zooming in, engines stop running, the wheat is coursing, a nuclear error. But I have no fear, cause London is drowning out. It was true. London calling at the top of the dial. And after all this, won't you give me a smile? London calling. I never felt so much alike.
We'll be right back. over here. Dance with me just for the hell.
Yeah. alligator. I'm a mama, papa coming for you. I'm a space invader. I'll be a rock and rolling bitch for you. Keep your mouth shut. Just smoke a like a big monkey bird. And I'm busting up a brain for the world.
Space, space, close to you hear your sailights taking you nowhere. The sky, life's begun. Nights are warm and the days are young. There's my baby lost, but so hooked on begging you save her little soul. Last night they loved you, opening doors and pulling some strings. Walk luck and you looked in time. Never look back, walk tall, act fine. My sweet, don't break my heart. Doing all right, you kinda get smart. Wish upon day, I believe, oh Lord, I believe. Run for the shadows, run for the shadows, run for the shadows in these golden years. There's my baby lost at all. Me hear you say light taking you nowhere.
Angel,
come for the baby. Run for the shadows, run for the shadows, run for the shadows.
Come.
That was Get Ready by Rare Earth. And before that, David Bowie was singing about those golden years. Coming up, we'll be hearing today's special on British people's problems, right here on Ruggid Radio.
Okay, I'll be in and out, no problem. I hate those stereotypical in-your-face salespeople, how they always rant on about some big sale.
Yeah, like some kind of autumn audio blowout sale, or how you can save big on car audio systems from $399.
Yeah, then they mention big companies like Sony or Yamaha, how they have free installation, and to call 962-1333, and the usual. Stop by today, 6 North Front Street, Belleville.
Yep, so stereotypical. He's touching me.
You leave your sister alone right now.
Stop touching me.
Cut it out.
She looked at me.
I will pull the car over right...
This time of the year, families will be in a hurry to get home. Unfortunately, some of these families won't make it there. You can help by donating some blood today at our clinic located on Dundas Street West. Open from 9 a.m. to 12 p.m. Thank you. Blood. It's in you to give.
Trust me, I know what I'm doing. I download music all the time. Let's just listen.
Oh my God! Shannon!
This wouldn't have happened at Sam the Record Man's music store. You can find the latest musician of any interest. Also, you can buy a copy of the new Black Keys album for only $12.99. You can also purchase a poster that's been personally autographed. Saturday only, so stop by the Quinney Mall and check us out.
All right, here it is. This is British People's Problems, right here on Rugged Radio.
Britain, the home of the British. The British are bound together by far more powerful and problematic forces, a unique set of behaviours and complicated social codes the rest of the world will never understand. Yes, even the greatest of Britons spend every waking moment blighted, hampered, and frustrated by very British problems. These might be problems, but they're our problems. Very British problems.
Brits can't greet each other. We're terrible. We're awkward. We're clumsy. We're rubbish at greeting.
If you shake someone's hand in the wrong way at a meeting, it's a make or break situation.
I'm very self-conscious about the fact I've got tiny hands. But what I'm really paranoid when I meet, you know, blokes with hands like shovels. I almost think they're going to take my hand and kiss it. You know, with girls, when you meet the fathers or the parents, you can just immediately sense the utter disappointment.
And it's all because of the French.
Having tried to inject a little continental sophistication into our interactions and failed, we certainly won't be making the same mistake with our over-friendly American cousins.
Have a nice day. I say, please, that's up to me to have a nice day. I don't need you to tell me to have one. I'm having a very nasty day at the moment. I don't know how it's going to go, but it's nothing to do with you.
Most Brits see right through that because they know it's not possible to have a nice day. You could say, have a nice quarter of an hour, and Brits would go, oh, thank you very much, because that's manageable. You can't have a good 15 minutes in this country without anything screwing up. Something's going to happen.
My parents went on holiday recently, and I sort of dropped them off, and I left them in the capable hands of one of the reps, whose name was Scott Richards, and I spent like an hour with him in his company, and Scott was great, you know, and I kept saying to my parents, so if you have any problems, you just need to ask Scott, and it was great. We were chatting away for ages, and he was really helpful. Then when it came to say goodbye, I said, OK, well, have a lovely holiday. And Scott, thank you so much. You've been really, really fantastic. And he went, actually, my name's Richard. It's Richard Scott. Oh. I basically insulted the guy, but he didn't say anything. Probably because he was being too polite and British and he didn't want to make me feel awkward. But then why did he tell me at the end? Just assume the new name, Scott, Richard, Scott.
Etiquette demands that you will neither ask a person to repeat nor clarify any details whatsoever.
When someone says something, the only thing I think you can do in that situation is laugh. You can only, when they say something, you just go... Or you laugh and then you look shocked and then say, oh, no.
Yeah.
You just go, oh, no. And you have to gauge it. Do you know what I mean?
It's the neutral. Oh, my God,
yeah.
Really?
Because saying what or pardon
can
for some reason is seen as rude, yeah.
Yeah. Or you just simply just say, I'm sorry, what are you talking about?
But that's what you want to say.
Yeah, you can't say that, though.
No, I can't.
You can't say that.
Though it has its drawback, this dignity-preserving arrangement is one we Brits are very happy with. And foreigners who refuse to play the game and insist on clarification can cause untold embarrassment.
I remember once being on a plane in America and asking a woman serving us, she said, do you want anything? I went, oh, I'd love some water. She went, wawa? I went, no, water, fizzy water. She went, fuzzy wawa? And I felt like saying, you're a fucking idiot. What's fuzzy wawa? Who's ever in the history of air travel gone on a plane and said, I would like some fuzzy wawa, please? Use what brain you have to work out what sounds like wawa that someone on a plane might like. Oh, water. You know, what could fuzzy be? Fizzy. It's not going to be anything else. And that's infuriating. But politely, I just went, no. And I tried to put on the American accent. I went, no, water, water, sparkling water. And then you think, I sound like an idiot. I sound like I'm doing a James Stewart impersonation. Why am I doing this? You're the person who's stupid, not me. And now you've made me the stupid person.
Who would go, who was not only not good at accents, but he would really go for it in a massive way. So if you went into a Chinese restaurant, it was agony. I would like the sweet and sour pork. And he wasn't taking the mickey. He just was trying to communicate. He was meeting them halfway, I think was how he'd have described it.
People say, oh, it's so lovely in the north. Everyone comes up to you at a bus stop and talks to you. And you just think, I know, that's why I left.
Trying to avoid so many people requires careful planning and clever strategies.
I live on a street where when I come around the corner, I often see some of my neighbours standing in their gardens, and I sometimes just go and hide around the corner and call on my phone for a bit because I don't want to talk to them.
People in a lift have license to be that close to you, but please let's not talk. Let's not engage. Let's not get to know one another. You just want to look down at the floor and wait for the bing pong, third floor, and then get out.
The boredom of it. Oh, just because they know everything about something that grows at the bottom of the sea does not mean they're good fun to be sitting next to at dinner.
Do not speak to me under any circumstances. Idle chit-chat is horrific.
I don't have a football team. I'm not bothered about telling people where I'm going on holiday and maybe I haven't done anything interesting that week.
Oh, good heavens. You're in the wrong place. The undertaker is next door.
But aren't you the doctor?
Oh, yes, I'm the doctor, all right. But I have my limitations, you know. I can't bring the dead back to life.
Men of my age go to the doctor to have a prostate test. And what that involves is you lying down on a bed and having the doctor put his finger up your arse. So I'd be quite happy with that if the doctor was quiet and just got on with his business, but he said to me he wanted to involve me in a conversation. So I laid down, trousers down, and then I felt the finger up the arse. And as he did it, he said, so, got a busy day today. I'm going, and I went along with it. I said, I'm going for a casting this afternoon, but how kind of you to inquire.
And it's not just physical contact. Even eye contact is to be avoided.
When you're on public transport, it's such a confined space that you're going to be making eye contact with someone. So you've got to just look around the person. And then you just look like a bit of a nutcase doing this with your eyes, just looking around everywhere. And then when someone's dazed or half asleep in the morning, they're just kind of gazing at you. And then you look away, look back, and they're still looking at you. You think, I'm going to get killed when I get off this tube. I'm going to get followed to the woods. It's not appropriate to start a conversation on public transport in England. If you spark up a conversation with someone, people look at you like you've lost the plot. It's like, who's this guy talking to me?
If someone sits down beside you on the bus and tries to speak, there's a small chance they might start masturbating.
I never use my phone on a train. I just can't do it. I've kind of pinned it down to the people who do have loud conversations on the mobiles, and this kind of middle management people. It's you don't get poor people bellowing down the phone so much. You don't get rich, but it's that kind of middle. It's people who are new to business who said, I can put that patio in and I'll have it done by the end of the week. And they might as well just stand up in the train and say, everybody, I lay patios, if you didn't know already.
I'd never tell anyone to be quiet, no.
I never say anything because I'm always too British and too polite to say anything. So if anything, I'll just kind of tattle. I'll take out my phone and I'll tweet to vent my anger so that everyone knows who follows me on Twitter that I'm angry. But also everyone knows that I'm not man enough to say anything.
An annoying passenger speaking loudly on the phone offends only one of your senses. But if they're eating, you have to hear them, see them, and put up with whatever smell they're wafting. Ugh, it should be illegal like it is in Singapore. 80% of Britons now live in towns and cities. We love the idea of a close-knit community. If only we knew how to talk to our neighbours.
It's important to know one side and that side, and then after that, and you're kind of on nodding terms, and then everything else is just unknown. You don't kind of... I think that the mark of a lunatic is getting to know everyone in the street.
If you go and knock on a neighbour's door, that's quite a thing to do. Your house better be on fire.
My neighbour cooks for me, and I always find one of the most difficult things being when do you take the plates back? That really... Like, sometimes I'll have a plate and I'll know that if I go around that I'll have to talk to them about some other kind of, like, local community things. So I'll keep the plate, but then the plate will play on my mind. Oh, it's exhausting, isn't it? It's just easy to just stay in the house and be one of those people that, like, when you do a murder, the only thing they knew about you is that they've seen you putting your bin out.
There is one extremely loaded phrase we British use on our house guests.
When I say make yourself at home, I don't mean it. Just honestly, just make yourself at home. Just to be clear, that is not what I mean. I mean, this isn't your home.
Make yourself at home is like the worst thing someone can say, because that really means be really careful. Take your shoes off. Don't put your feet on the couch or on my table, and be careful of everything you do.
There's something very, very strange about the person that just opens your fridge. Have you had that? Have you had the person come round and just open your fridge and it's like, what do you think this is? MTV Cribs? I just grab a drink. So, what's going on? You can't take a drink from my fridge. You've got to ask me and then I will say the phrase, help yourself. And you will then say, no, no, I can't. And I'll go, sure. And by that point, we're fine, because I know that you're legit and OK.
We say stuff that we, to be polite, but we don't really mean it. It's like when I go to my wife's mum and dad's, like the first few times, I'd always offer to wash up, just so that I've been seen to offer. But if she'd have turned around and gone to me, oh, and you crack on, I'd have been absolutely devastated.
I hate it when they claim they've got a bed and then it's an air bed or something like that.
Yeah.
That's totally unacceptable. If you have to sleep in their sitting room and then they get up and they start acting like it's a normal morning, you're like, this is my bedroom, legally. This is my bedroom now. Until I make the decision to get up, you're not allowed in.
Yeah.
So what have we learnt about the basics of very British problems? As soon as one British person encounters another one, we find social awkwardness at every turn, from saying hello to saying goodbye. We've developed clever ways to avoid each other, but that can lead to even more problems. Anyway, I better be off. I'll see you next week. This has been fun, though. Bye. Bye. Yeah. Bye. Have a great week. Bye. Okay.
The boredom of it. Oh.
An 80-year-old couple set in our resort.
Bye!
Did you like that? Did you? Did you really?
Well, now it's time for the Monks with their song Drugs in Me Pocket on Ruggid Radio. Oh my.
got some real hard drops. All the way from Jamaica for some good stuff. Try some of these. Oh, I'll have a go. Hang on. Cool, that's all right, isn't it?
Get to That by Funkadelic. I warned you, I told you I was busting at the funk. Better be careful now. You better be careful. Watch yourself. Here on Ruggid Radio. Club.
searching for something. Which always seems to be such a
you might need to just mad about saffron. Well, saffron's mad about me. I'm just mad about saffron. She's just mad about me. They call me mellow yellow, quite rightly. They call me mellow yellow, quite rightly. They call me mellow yellow. I'm just mad about 14. 14's mad about me. I'm just mad about 14. She's just mad about me. They call me mellow yellow. They call me mellow yellow. Quite rightly. They call me mellow yellow. A wind of a loss of tenille. Wanna have forever to fly. If you want your cup, power fill. They call me mellow yellow, quite rightly. They call me mellow yellow, quite rightly. They call me mellow yellow.
Hung the leaves with
with tears. I want you near to kill my fears, to help me to leave all my blues behind. For standing in your heart is where I want to be and long to be. How about I may as well try and catch the wind.
Like a bus stop running up the stairs, gonna meet you on the rooftop.
But at night it's a different world. Go out and find a girl. Come on and dance all night. Just like the heat, it'll be alright. And babe, don't you know it's a pity the days can't be like the nights in the summer, in the city, in the summer, in the city.
back of my neck getting dirt and gritty. Been down, isn't it a pity? Doesn't seem to be a shadow in the city. All around, people looking half dead, walking on the sidewalk harder than a match head. But tonight it's a different world. Go out and find a girl. Come on, and dance all night. Despite the heat, it'll be alright. And babe, don't you know it's a pity the days can't be like the nights in the summer in the city. Summer in the city.
Get on up, meet
the ducks with a bun. They all come out to groove about, be nice and have fun in the sun. Tell you what I'll do.
What will you do?
I'd like to go there now with you. You can miss out school.
Won't that be cool?
Why go to learn the words of fool?
What will we do there?
We'll get high.
What will we touch there?
We'll touch the sky.
We'll try the cheese there.
I'll tell you why.
It's all too beautiful. It's all too beautiful. It's all too beautiful. It's all too beautiful.
I feel inclined to blow my mind. Get hung up, feed the ducks with a bun. They all come out to groove about, be nice and have fun in the sun.
It's all too beautiful. It's all too beautiful. It's all too beautiful. Ha! It's all too beautiful. It's all too beautiful. It's all too beautiful. It's all too beautiful.
Here we come, walking down the street. We get the funniest looks from everyone we meet.
Hey, hey, we're the Monkees, and people say we monkey around. But we're too busy singing to put anybody down.
We go where we want to, do what we like to do. We don't have time to get restless. There's always something new.
Hey, hey, we're the Monkees, and people say we monkey around. But we're too busy singing to put anybody down. We're just trying to be friendly. Come and watch us sing and play. We're the young generation, and we've got something to say. Oh.
Anytime or anywhere, just look over your shoulder. Guess who'll be standing there?
Hey, hey, we're the Monkees. People say we monkey around, but we're too busy singing to put anybody down.
Wow. One
say we monkey around, but we're too busy singing to put anybody down. We're just trying to be friendly. Come and watch us sing and play. We're the young generation, and we've got something to say.
She's a wonderful lady and she's mine, all mine. And there doesn't seem a way that she won't come and lose my mind. It's too easy humming songs to a girl in yellow dress. It's been a long time since the party and the room is in a mess. The four kings of EMI are sitting stately on the floor. There are birds out on the sidewalk and a valet at the door. He reminds me of a penguin with few and plaster hairs, talcum powder on the
I've been waiting for an hour, I can't find a place to hide. The being known as Wonder Girl is speaking, I believe. It's not easy trying to tell her that I shortly have to leave. Why don't you yell at me? Why don't you stop and see? Why don't you hate who I hate, kill who I kill to be free?
Saturated liver, and I wish I could forgive her, but I do believe she meant it when she told me to forget it. And I bet you will forget it when they find me in the morning, wet and drowned, and the wood gets round. I'm going down, I'm going down. I'm coming up for air, it's pretty stuff under there. I'd like to say I didn't care, but I forgot to leave a note, and it's so hot to stay afloat. I'm soaking wet without a boat, and I knew I should have taken off my shoes. It's front page news. Going down. She must have had another date. I didn't need this extra weight. I wish that I could see the way to show. I don't want no more. Going down, I'm going down. And now I see the left, I let it slip it all away. I made a shuttle on the swimming set, and now it's really got me stuff. I can't believe it. Why I jump a light again? My tummy pump, I can't believe they drink this stuff in town. This dirty brown. Scene is getting old. I'm hungry, sleepy, wet and cold. She told me to forget it nice. I should have taken her advice. I only want to go on home. I'd gladly leave that girl alone. What a way to spend the night. If I don't drown, I'll die of fright. But Pappy taught me how to float, but I can't swim a single note. He threw me in to teach me how. I stayed there floating like a mama cow, and now I've floated way downstream. No, this has to be a dream. If I could find my way to shore, I'd never, never do this anymore. Look, if you three up and down, but I'm going down. Just one more pebble now. It's getting light, everything will be alright. Think I've finally got the knack of just floating and lazy on my back. I never really liked that town. I think I'll ride the river down, just moving slow and floating free. There's a river swinging under me, waving back to the slopes on shore. I should have thought of this before I float on down to New Orleans and pick up on some swinging scenes. I'm gonna know a better day. I'm gonna get moving all the way.
society. You're using all the tricks that you used on me. You're reading all them high fashion magazines. The clothes you're wearing, girl, are causing public scenes. I said, I'm not just stepping stones. Shoes, but now you're walking around like your front page news. You've been awful careful about the friends you choose, but you won't find my name in your book of who's who's. I said, I'm not your stepping stone.
That was a double shot of Stevie Wonder with Signed, Sealed, and Delivered. And before that, Superstition. Oh, that song means we're out of time here on Ruggid Radio. Sadly, it's the end of the show. Tune in next week to hear a special on how the Beatles formed and how they broke up, and also what caused the breakup, right here on Ruggid Radio. Well, take care, people, and until next time, good night, everybody.
And I'll never